morning, amazing Infinity family. I'm back here again with my next Fortnite video. Okay, and in this video, I want to address something which is coming to me again and again, and I've explained this to many people. So either they have not understood, or somewhere the uplines are not drilling down this in the head of people till last level, actually, right? That is nothing but why I always, you know, do not agree to sign up people left, right, center in different cities. When people come and ask me, can I sign up somebody in this city? Can I sign up somebody in that city? I always ask question after that, right? Okay, after sign up what? Sometimes people come to me and they say, you are going to this city, can I send my prospect to meet you? You know, you have a system in Kuwait, can I send my prospect to or my new sign up to system actually to attend and all that, right? My next question to always to them is, suppose if they go there and they get switched on after that, what will you do? Okay, and most of them, they don't have any plan ready, they don't have any consistency of visits there actually ready. So guys, I want to first make you understand what is this business all about. Okay, this business is nothing, but this business is about building yourself, okay, first, and then while building yourself, you help few more people to build themselves. You know, business will get built automatically, but first we have to build ourselves, okay, in terms of skill, in terms of mindset, in terms of leading by example and all these things, right? And then you have to build someone else also, okay, who's working with you while you're building yourself, right? Okay, now how do you build yourself? The only way to build yourself is basically, okay, work on the ground, okay, and push yourself in doing something which you are not comfortable doing actually. Push yourself more and more and keep doing things in which you are not really expert actually, right? You know, keep doing things till the time you don't get result, right? So that you become better and better, okay? So that's why exactly I tell people to build the team where they are based actually, in the city where they're based, so that they can keep pushing themselves, okay? Even if they're not getting their DRs, they have to start pushing themselves to talk to more people, you know, that will help them to shed the inhibition, and that will, you know, that will help them to become better in people's skill, and then pushing themselves. And then while doing that, they can demonstrate to other people also who are already with them that how they are doing it, right? And this is how exactly other people will also learn. Other people will change and learn looking at you, that you are leading by example, you already have that skill developed already because you pushed yourself in past in the same city and everywhere actually, right? But what if you start signing up people, you know, left, right and center in different cities, right? Generally what happened when people, you know, initially people sign up people actually in their own city actually, right? But after 5, 7, 8, you know, obviously getting DRs become difficult because you start moving from a hot zone or warmer zone to warm, you know, to the zone actually which is close to warm and cold zone actually, right? Okay, or acquainted people, and obviously that they will not trust the way the hot zone and warm zone trust you. Okay, so obviously that time you will have their ratio of closing will be lower, you know, you until unless you push yourself, you will not be able to pull out the result from this activity. So the only way is to keep doing and become better and then drive the result, right? And that will make you an expert networker, right? But rather than doing that, what people do, they start hunting actually. Okay, I'm not getting a sign up in this city. Okay, I have a friend there who's like a warm zone and who's like a hot zone. So why not signing up the guy there, right? So rather than pushing themselves to get more skill and do stuff which they were uncomfortable doing, okay, which will make them better if they keep doing that, okay, rather than doing that, they start going out and start looking out for people in different towns who are close to them, okay, and that is easy actually, right? Because in that case, you don't have to push yourself, you just have to talk to them, and mostly if they trust you, they will come. But the point is that even if they come, even if they get excited, even if they believe in the business, do you have any plan or capacity or capability to go there and support them? Even if you're ready to go there and support them, okay, first of all, financially, is it going to be viable for you? Because going there is not once in a month. Going there is not like 1 week in a month. Going there means every week you have to be there with that person for 2 to 3 days, right? And that's how exactly any person gets built. Because understand, when you are in your own town, you are there with those people every day, right? And then only they can see the way you are demonstrating, the way you are leading by example. You know, is it possible to visit 1 week a month to for someone, okay, somewhere, and demonstrate how things to be done and change the mindset and everything actually, right? You will not be able to take the mind share of that person itself, right? Okay, and then what will happen? Okay, you will stop going because that person will not keep you enough busy, and then you'll stop going, and then one more sleeping IR you will create actually, right? Okay, so guys, you know, and also one more thing, if in the existing city, if you've not created a big team, if you're not leading by example, if you've not done enough DR, right? Do you think even if you are in a position to go outside 3 days a week also, okay, you think you will be able to teach that person? Because the fact is that you yourself have not learned. Because if you would have learned, you would have created that in your own city as well, right? Okay. So please understand, do not start any market or any, do not sign up anybody where you cannot support, right? Now people also, they say, system is there. Can I send them to the system? Can I send them to Dubai? Suppose if my person isn't there in Dubai, can I send them to Dubai VCon, right? My point is that if you've signed them up as a hot zone, suppose they were close relatives or brother or sister, and if you have no plan to go and support them for a few years, right? But you wanted to give them position, that's why exactly you signed them up as a hot zone, right? Because it's only the family member, right? Okay, so why you are trying to send them to VCon, or why you are trying to send them to system actually, right? Because if you send them to VCon or system, they get switched on. If they get switched on, after that, what is the plan? Are you going to be there for them? No. So basically, you're making them making an IR switch on and then leaving them on the road. You know, some they will go and bang themselves actually with a wall actually, because they don't know what to do. And most of the people, they once they get the switch on IR outside their own city, they keep talking to them on phone and keep giving them gyan and everything actually, right? Okay, and they're not there physically with them. If you're not there physically with them, why you're giving gyan? Don't give gyan unnecessarily. Don't try to activate them. If I am there at your place, I will give them actually sleeping pill and make them sleep for some time till the time I'm not able to go there and really work with them on the ground. Because the only way to teach is working with them on the ground, not on the call and giving a lot of gyan, because you know a lot of things, right? Please understand, okay? And now, the reason why you're doing this is because you are free. You don't have too much of work. You are not pushing yourself to do the activities in your own city, your own town, talk to more people, strangers, you know, networking activity and all. So you are free. So what to do? I have an IR in that town who's basically positive. So let me give him some gyan, right? But understand, you are actually spoiling that person itself, right? Because you are taking away the innocence from that person. You may not understand what I'm talking right now, but I'm talking with my experience, right? Okay. So I always did only one thing, okay? Even if I signed up a hot zone somewhere, right? I didn't even discuss the business with them. I didn't even told them what is the business, because suppose my sister, my brother, my cousin actually, right? I didn't even told them about the business, right? I just told them, okay, they are there, my partner, somewhere in some business. I will tell them one day, right? Okay, why I never wanted to tell them anything? Because even if I explain the business, they may get switched on looking at the business, and even if I tell them not to talk to somebody, they will go out and talk to somebody actually, right? Okay, and two things will happen. Either if they talk to somebody, that person will be ready to sign up, or that person will be negative, right? If that person will be negative, this IR of mine will also be negative again, right? Okay, will not be able to take that rejection, because that strength is not built, that belief is not come, right? Suppose if that IR signs up, then bigger issue, right? Why? Because there was only one person in that town, which is my hot zone example. Okay, now unnecessarily I showed him the plan and he showed it to somebody else, and that guy also signed up, which means there are now two people and I have no plan to go there, right? Correct. I don't have a bandwidth to support them, right? So obviously if first person signed up, but there'll be 20 more negative people will come after that, right? So actually I'm making two sleeping IR there, and I'm killing two people's dream actually over there, right? Okay, so guys, please understand, when you are building this business, the first thing is to build yourself. Building yourself means, if in the existing place, if you cannot do networking, if you cannot push yourself and get more DR, if you cannot, you know, increase your skill, if you cannot just increase your closing ratio and everything, right? Okay, then there's no point going anywhere else, because you will do the same thing in other town also, right? And you will not be able to lead by example, right? So why not addressing this issue first, right? Okay, that you have to improve first, right? And for that, what you need to do, you have to keep doing things for a longer period of time, thinking that there's no other option, right? Why, how it happened with me? Because I had no other choice. I had no upline, okay, who I can tell, okay, I have a person there, can you meet them, right? So that's why I had known people in Bombay. I was living in Pune in the beginning. But still, I never sent anybody to any of the upline, because I had no upline or any system actually, right? Till the time I was not ready to go to Bombay, I didn't even spoke to anybody in Bombay actually about the business, right? Okay. Though my 90% of my career happened in Bombay actually, right? Still, why? Because I was knowing that there is no choice. I have to learn it from here itself, right? Again, understand, it is all about building yourself first, you know? And no matter what you think, no matter how you justify, my dears, this is why this is not happening, that is why it is not happening, believe me, you don't know how to do it. You don't know how to do it, and you're not pushing yourself enough. It's okay not to know, right? But the problem is that it's not okay not to accept. It's not okay that, you know, that you don't want to improve and you're finding shortcuts actually, right? Okay, and wasting time. So please understand, the only thing you need to do is you increase your skills by pushing yourself, by doing something where you know, which is the basics of the networking in the place where you are living actually, right? Okay, and then once you become expert there, then you will be able to build other markets also, because you will become an expert, right? Okay, and please do not wake up, you know, unnecessary, wake up people left, right, center, anywhere. Please understand, without your support on the ground, nothing will happen. So please, or else your somebody from your upline should be ready to take the responsibility of that person. Then it is okay. If you have your uplines there in that town, okay, then it's fine, right? But don't depend on the cross line, right? Don't depend on the cross line, on the system or anybody, right? Okay, system is okay. It's a reference point where a person can go and learn basics, right? But something one need to learn on the field, which is basically the groundwork, and that need to be done by some upline in front of that person, and that will teach that person more, right? Systems will help after this, right? After this, because once the person will learn on the ground, and then he will go to the system, he will understand, oh, I was not doing this, I'm not doing that, this, right? But understand, you cannot just rely on the system and, you know, and just your phone calls and few visits actually to that place to build a market actually, right? Okay, second thing is most important. Once you start, suppose if you are capable of doing that, you already did 20 plus DRs, you know how to do networking, and you start going to a new market, right? When you go to a new market, please understand, in your head, drill it down, 3 years. 3 years every week, 2 to 3 days, right? Are you willing to commit? Because 3 years minimum will be required, right? It's like a newborn baby. A newborn baby takes at least 3 years to be independent, right? Okay, I've seen people going there, initially team increase, and the moment team increase, they start showing plans also, right? And then the person feel, oh, I don't need to go there, because they know how to do the plans. But guys, understand, your role in that market change every 3 months. Initially, you're doing a lot of plans, every meeting is done by you, but then one or two people start duplicating that, right? Okay, so your role change. Then your role change, basically you have to build their mindset also, interpersonal issue also start, you know, you have to identify the leadership also there, you have to sit there to give energy also. You know, I never stopped going to any market in less than 3 years, right? Okay, like for example, today I'm going to Vietnam, okay? I don't do any plan at all. I don't do any new IR meeting actually, right? But still every month I'm there without fail. Because if I'm not there, how will I find out the gap in the team? How will I understand that what are the interpersonal issues between the people? How will I identify that who need to improve in which area actually, right? Okay. And, you know, when you keep going after the team is growing and there are people who are already taken charge, right? You become a glue to the team actually, right? Every time you go there, the team come together, right? And there's a different energy, right? And that is required for 3-4 years. That's why exactly minimum 3 years I said, right? And after that also continue to go, okay? Maybe the visits will reduce, right? Okay? So guys, understand, you even if the results are not coming, you have to keep going. And if you are committed for that, then only start any new market, right? Okay? You cannot just stop going because this is not happening, that is wrong. Maybe you will, when you start the market, you will start because of one person or two people, right? Okay? And those two people will get vanished actually, right? But you have to understand that you started the market because of those two people, but you don't have to be depending on those two people, right? Maybe you will go deep down somewhere and you will find a leader actually, right? And all my different legs, I was checking the virtual office the other day and I saw that there are 14 legs. There are 14 DR legs which are actually working actually in my genealogy, right? 14 DR legs of mine, right? Which means 14 different organizations originated from my 14 different DRs, right? Okay. But the beauty is, you know what? Out of those 14, okay, do you know that only 5 DRs are still working, but out 9 actually, 9 organizations, those DRs are gone, but before they left the business, they gave me somebody, and that person gave me somebody, and that person gave me somebody who's a leader today, right? Okay? So please understand, you know, this business is all about building yourself first. And while building yourself, you help others to build actually, right? And for that, you have to be in proximity. You have to spend a lot of time. You have to be there every day. You have to take their mind share actually, right? Okay? And that is only possible when you do it in the beginning in your city actually, right? Okay? And when you start building other market, you have to be there for 3 days, 2 days, a week minimum, so that you are there with them for 3 years, 2-3 days a week. You can take their time share. You can build them on the ground. They can see everything, what you're doing and leading by example, right? So guys, it's a well elaborated explanation. Now, I hope people will understand and they will not try and find shortcuts to get DRs and shortcuts to make the organization run actually, right? Okay? Organization will run and fly if you improve yourself and if you push yourself on something which you were not doing it for a long time, right? Okay? Thank you very much and I'll see you again in next fortnight. Love you guys.